Okay, welcome to the Lord of the Rings Tales of Middle-Earth Early Access event. I am about to fire a premiere draft. That means best of one draft. But before we get to that, you can level up your game with CFB Pro articles from some of the best players in the world. We're going to have tons of Lord of the Rings content. We have tons already, and we'll be having more as soon as our writers get a chance to play with the cards. And you'll be the first to know about everything we learn. That is, if you visit the Channel Fireball website and consider signing up for CFB Pro, it's only $7 a month. Thanks also to Ultimate Guard for being a longtime supporter of me and my teammates and my content. They're part of what makes this possible. And thanks to you for being here and for listening. Let's get to it. We have the Watcher in the Water. So this is all about drawing cards during opponent's turns. That seems like a lot to ask, but Bitter Downfall and Gothmog are both great. I've had Legolas in both my decks so far. Not, I don't think something I'd first pick, but certainly good if you're already playing blue and green. Standout commons, I guess, Chance Met Elves and Lash of the Balrog, but I'm certainly going to take one of these black uncommons, and I think it's going to be Bitter Downfall. Goldberry, River Daughter. Move a counter of each kind not on Goldberry. All right, so you get to move counters around, and when you do, you draw a card. So this is actually at its best in blue-black when you have a mass. So I'll have a close look at that. Fiery Inscription. And then these are all playable black commons, but I think I'm going to go for Goldberry and try to build blue-black. So we're looking for a mass. Or just blue-black control. Rosy Cotton is powerful. This is like a tokens payoff card. Ranger's Firebrand is powerful. We have Isolation. We have a Swamp Cycler. Well, if I was going to just go on the blue-black plan, I think I would take the Troll. But it seems to me that the power level difference is high enough that I should consider taking Rosy Cotton or Ranger's Firebrand. I'm going to take Ranger's Firebrand. Isolation is a decent removal spell, but you can just see the difference in the efficiency between the one mana play and the four mana play. All right, Gandalf Sanction, X damage, X equal number of instant sorcery cards. So you're seeing like a blue-red spells matter thing come together. If that Fiery Inscription was to come around, for example, but who knows if that's going to happen. This is a fine card. This is a fine card. So I'm going to take Gandalf Sanction. So some combination of the Grixis colors. Wow, could have had two Wind Lords. I don't know how easy it is to play that for less than six mana. Errand Rider is really strong white common. If I had taken the Rosy Cotton, I'd be interested in that. But finally, we're seeing some good black cards with the Gore Bag and the Lash. Rally at Hornburg is fine and is a spell for purposes of Gandalf Sanction. I think I'm going to take Gore Bag. My draft's like feeling a little confused right now, but I'm fine just saying, okay, I'm some combination of the Grixis colors. Bill Ferney, just a lot of text for basically a little better than a two mana 2/1. Goblin Fire Leaper. That's a pretty good card, especially like Black Red Sacrifice. We have two different options for Land Cyclers. Maybe I'll wind up being Black Red. Okay, the Morgul Knife Wound, I'm fine with that. Bewitching Leechcraft. I think it's Leechcraft or Lash. I think I'm most likely to be black of the three colors, so I'll take the Lash. I'm red-black seems to be a fairly dedicated sacrifice color combination. And if I'm doing blue-black with Goldberry, I want to have a lot of amass cards, so I think Lash will work out pretty good. Legolas and Chance Met Elves came around, but I'm looking more at Sam's Desperate Rescue or Birthday Escape. I don't have super strong creatures, so I think I'm going to take Birthday Escape. Hopefully I won't miss the Sam's Desperate Rescue. Okay, Mordor Muster. This is just what I want. This, you know, the amassing for like sacrifice synergies or Goldberry if I decide to play that. So now I'm feeling like I'm going to be black with either red or blue. Notably, the Fiery Inscription did not wheel, so maybe there's another person at the table trying to do a blue-red Spells Matter thing. This is just a good card. Boy, I'm not the biggest fan of the Orcish Medicine. Just take the creature. Well, bunch of red coming around late. Maybe I should be looking at red-black as my first choice. Okay, Isildur's Fateful Strike. I think this is kind of not as good as the common and uncommon removal spells. Like, I think, for example, it's not as good as Bitter Downfall. But it's still fine, especially when you factor in that your Ring Bearer is always going to be legendary. But I can just choose Claim the Precious over Isildur's Fateful Strike. I like the book. I guess Eomer is pretty strong. I think I'm going to take Claim the Precious, and then if I was to wheel Fateful Strike, book, Eomer, even like Breaking the Fellowship, I'd be pretty happy here. The Mouth of Sauron. You can target yourself, so that's cool. That's certainly a strong card. Another Mordor Muster. So I have more red cards, but I'm not super excited about any of them besides the Ranger's Firebrand. So I think I should still be open to blue-black. The Retired Burglar. Enters or leaves the battlefield, the ring tempts you. Make some treasures. I'm going to take Bilbo. I'm still planning to be black and either red or blue. But maybe there's some scenario where I get some mana fixing and wind up going three colors. Shelob's Ambush, I think, is like the best card in black or red. But my deck's going to be pretty low on creatures, more of like a control deck. So I don't think I'm going to super miss any of these cards, and Bilbo has the highest upside. Oh, interesting. Fall of Care Andros. Whenever a creature an opponent controls dealt excess non-combat damage. So it's like a super late game win condition. Here's another shot at a Fiery Inscription. Jeez. What do I do? I don't know. I guess I'm going to take it. I have no idea if this card is good. It might just be like useless, like way too slow. But I guess I'd rather try it than ignore it. Galadriel's obviously quite powerful. This pack has a lot of just green cards and nothing great for me. But I'll just go ahead and take the Rohirrim. Could have so many Fiery Inscriptions. I guess I'm probably just red-black. Blue has seemed like it's getting cut more than red is. Well, here's Shire Terrace. Could see a world where I play red-black and splash Mouth of Sauron and Gandalf Sanction or something. But for now, the way to build a functional deck is just to be red-black. Another Fiery Inscription. I'm gonna take the Land Cycler. Dunland Crebane. If I was still on the blue path, I'd be somewhat interested in Lorien Revealed, but I think this is just good. All right, claim the precious. That's a gift. Is Fiery Inscription good in draft? I think it can be good if you build around it. If you're just playing a normal deck and a normal game, then it's like you take a turn off to play Fiery Inscription, then they just attack you and deal a bunch of damage. then you're going to play, like, what, two or three instants or sorceries later over the course of the game. So it's not good in a normal deck, but if you have blue-red with a bunch of cantrips, it can certainly be a real plan. Rise of the Witch King as possible splash. Think I just take another Land Cycler. Ooh. If I had seen that earlier, I would be much more into the blue-black thing, blue-black plan. It's the best card. The best card for me is the Mordor Muster. But I'm going to take Saruman. Ooh, Ranger's Firebrand coming late. Another Shire Terrace. I think I should just probably build a red-black deck. I think that's going to be the best outcome for me. I have some interesting stuff if I was to tap into blue, but I think I need to just show some discipline. The Goblin Fire Leaper can deal non-combat damage. Sam's Desperate Rescue is fine, especially now that I have three Olifants, three Land Cyclers. So I'm guessing 16 lands is going to be correct. Maybe 9-7 plus the Olifants. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. With the Erebor Flamesmiths being the weakest of my two drops. I think I'm just going to not play this. So like this. You would draw a card while you have no cards in hand. Draw two instead. It's a cool card. Rosy Cotton of Saffling. Wow, popping off. So what? What are we representing here? I'm just gonna block. The flavor. Just getting buried in flavor. I'm gonna lose to the file of Galadriel. I think this thing is a bomb. Looks amazing. Thank you. Wow, upkeep. Such a nice play. Any of your end stuff you don't control food, create a food token. Whenever another non-token creature enters the battlefield under your control, create a food. Return historic cards from your graveyard to your hand. Yee! Man, the whole population of the Shire is just kicking my ass right now. Yep, I'm ready to pack it in. Good game. The single biggest problem there was the file of Galadriel. because my hand was just so reactive, all removal spells. But also, my opponent's deck was pretty sweet with all the food synergies. Some of these lands are really powerful. Create two treasure tokens more or less for free. Could really use a land for next turn. What do you say? What do you say? What say you? You say four drop. Well, this game's not going well either. This is the Witch King of Angmar, one of the best cards in the format. Oh wow, so you always amass zero orcs, which means you get triggers. Powerful. Alright, I don't think I want to play a game where I'm mana screwed against the Witch King of Angmar, so we're gonna go to game number 3 and try to get back on track. Uh-oh, I'm against an opponent who's already made it to silver. Clearly way out of my league. Menace. Should I just kill that thing right away? I think the answer is no. Reid, are you going to do a video or anything on cards from Lord of the Rings you think are relevant for the modern, for the PT? Yeah, that's... We are just... We've got a whole team of players working really hard at exactly that on Channel Fireball. So you can check the YouTube channel, you can check the main website, even TCG Player Infinite. That's basically all we're doing right now is finding the best ways to use the Lord of the Rings cards. Alright, well, it's my opponent who's missing land drops this time. I don't really have any way to capitalize. I think I just do nothing. Okay, so I'm pretty flooded, but if I get one more Temptation of the Ring, which I can get as soon as my opponent plays a creature worth killing, then I can start looting. And that can maybe be good for me. Well, I refuse to believe that my opponent has nothing that they can cast. After missing a land drop and now having five cards, like what can possibly be going on over there? I'm stumped. Man, how do you just not play anything for 5 mana? What's up, Jeff? How are you? Thanks for stopping by the stream. Well, I'm on the board at least. Should I mountain cycle? I think the answer is yes. Well, just gonna take my medicine here. So my opponent's going to be way ahead on cards, but a bit behind on board presence. And if their next two turns are just like tap out to play one creature, then I have these removal spells and can keep pressing my advantage. Not sure why I played the mountain there instead of the swamp. Yes. Just gonna take it slow. So just choosing to shuffle the Dunland Crevane into the library. Thank you. Right. So 6-4 trample. And a 4-1 trample. I can always use the Bitter Downfall at instant speed if I need it. And might as well get in with the Orc army as well. So if they make this block, they're actually going to be dead, because the Bitter Downfall is 1 from the Flamesmith, 2 from the ability of the spell, then they would take 10 trample. Because if you remove the blocker, the Oliphant just tramples over for the full amount. One, plus two, plus four, plus six, plus 13. And I've now evened it up at 2-2. A missed land drop from my opponent, so I'm going to fire off the Mordor Trebuchet. Yeah, Pro Tour Barcelona does have 2 booster drafts with Lord of the Rings, so it's 10 rounds of Modern, 6 rounds of booster draft, all featuring Lord of the Rings cards. Okay, so a good play here is to have the Ring tempt me, make my Orc the Ring Bearer. Then I can attack with that being unblockable and get in the trebuchet damage as well. Thank you. Ouch. Wow. That was a brutal swing. I don't even really have much counterplay to that besides just playing my 2-2, and now I'm firmly on the defensive. So now my ring bearers are looting, although I traded off my ring bearer, so now I'll need another temptation in order to make a new ring bearer. Leaves the battlefield, the ring tempts you, and then you can return it from your graveyard to your hand. Got it. Well, I can win if my opponent has nothing, but if they have a way to remove the Holy Fount, then it's going to be very, very bad for me. That's going to be the end of this draft. I have to settle for, I think it was 2 and 3. It wasn't the most impressive draft deck. Had good removal, but not a super coherent theme, and I think no rares. So, certainly not the dream deck. But you can learn a lot from what your opponents are up to, too. That File of Galadriel is a really scary card. I'm going to basically pick that every time I see it from now on, and seeing what some of the food synergy decks can do was fun as well. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed it.